San Francisco, one of the admins of Comic Book Fans United. I'm here at the Comics of all this people. We are raising money for Artworks, the Naomi Cohen Foundation, and Wendy Eisman in her battle for cancer. If you like any of the art that you will see in this video, it is available on eBay.com. The exact address will be underneath, right here somewhere. And it's for two really good causes.
Hi! Hello, my name is Lily Gonzalez. I don't know if you can hear me right now. I'm trying to project as loudly as I possibly can. This is my piece right here. It's called The Good, the Bad, and the Uncanny. It's taken from the Silver Surfer comic, volume 1, number 4 to be exact. This took me a very long time, about like 2 weeks, I believe.
Hello, my name is Catherine Kelly. I am the program coordinator for Artworks for the Naomi Cohen Foundation. And we were so happy to be contacted by Comic Book Fans United for this wonderful event. They contacted us because they wanted to reach out to a charity that focused on children in New Jersey and art. And that is exactly right up our alley. We deliver the healing power of the arts to children going through chronic and life-threatening illnesses all throughout New York and New Jersey. We deliver supplies to the kids, we run shows for them twice a year, and we also put professional artists in the hospitals to show the kids how to make these. So we're very much in tune with the art world in New York and New Jersey, and we're very supportive of the art scene.
Hey, I didn't see you there. I'm Carlos from Between Two Beards. This is my lovely girlfriend here, Paula. She's actually a mute, it's fine. I'm gonna talk to her. This is her piece that she did. It's obviously Lion Cat, the saga. And she sat next to me in bed when she was drawing this and painting it. And as you can see, there's like legitimately 6 million little lines. And she sat next to me, just kept drawing lying. And most of the time she was completely wasted. So it went pretty well. I mean, it came out pretty nice. I can't draw a straight line when I'm drunk, but she did a pretty good job. Good job. Is there anything else you'd like to add?
I'm Wendy Eisman. One of the other people that the amazing folks at CBFU are going to be helping out, I have stage 4 head and neck cancer. Tumor up inside my sinuses. I am now currently getting radiation twice a day and chemotherapy once a week. As you can imagine, that's a very expensive process. I'm having to pay over $1,100 per month to keep health insurance during this massive treatment. The folks at CBFU were kind enough to step forward to offer to help me with some of these expenses. I was very, very touched when they did. I had known we're going through work. We started playing around on the Facebook page and there, as well as the Fans page. I've always loved comics. My bride and joy has always loved comics. So we're both girls, genuine ones. And I go back to the Silver Age with some of the ones I remember. It's being able to share that sense of history plus my knowledge of independence. And being asked to receive this kindness is very, very touching. And any help is deeply, deeply appreciated. This is a good group of people. And they really touch my heart deeply. And I want to thank anyone who's come out to support this sale. And with this art, treasure it. I treasure any help. Thank you.
My name is Shrika Berg. I'm an independent artist and an art educator.
of Rodin's classical sculpture, La Fenêtre, which is based on a Greek myth. Usually, poison ivy is shown as being like an overtly sexual character, so I wanted to show her as someone more humanized and someone more vulnerable. So she's shown instead of in, you know, a very aggressive stance, she's very vulnerable, bent over, and almost cradled by her ivy. Her main weapon is that her kiss kills, which is kind of like tragic in a way because she's isolated. Because if she did ever fall in love with someone, she could never kiss them. And die. Unless it was maybe like Superman. But that's a whole nother backstory.
I'm Carlos from Between Two Beards, and I'm here discussing a piece brought here by one of my best friends in this world, Devale Achamue, that's how it's pronounced in Syria, but it's Deville Lemieux. One time when we were in high school, I rock bottomed through a table, that happened, and one time he took his testicles out, and I threw a violator head at his balls, and I hit it, and I cut it open. But this is the tick. He drew that, and it's pretty nice. I think somebody should buy this. It's very well done. Look at this frame. This frame is at least 30 pounds. I don't know how much it's going to add to the shipping cost on eBay. Oh, Deville just died, so this is a very rare piece. You should buy it right now for $7. Just kidding. That's by the shipping. It costs at least $70.